I had this guy who came up to me in Jodhpur in the middle of the shooting, and he was like, you know, I am the chef here, and I just want to tell you that I watched the film and I courted my wife. Every day I would take her to watch a DDLJ. And on the 25th time, she finally married me because I proposed to her during the film. Then I had another person who came to me that, you know, we love DDLJ so much where we decided to buy the DVD, and because we watched it so many times, our kids watched it. And I was like, wow, it's like a tradition going down the years, you know.
I must say that when I first saw DDLJ way back in the 90s, I never ever figured that DDLJ could play such an important role as part of what I did, say 10 or 20 years later. I think that movie created a space in every single bride's mind today. It's something that left a very lasting impression in terms of how the overall wedding story should be. So today when I speak to people, so even if it's not a direct DDLJ reference, everyone wants images, everyone wants memories that is in some form influenced by the kind of styles that DDLJ brought into Indian cinema.
And I was like, let's just do like a whole mint green outfit, and which became very, very popular. In fact, lots of the fabric stores sold that color, meters and meters of that color.
Messages were coming that where do I find a Raj in my life, or a boy saying, I want to find a Simran, you know, things like that. It had got into the psyche of the youth.
A lot of young actresses and girls that I meet, they say, you spoiled love for us. There is no Raj, we keep looking for Raj. And I'm like, are you like Raj? I said, no, I'm not like Raj. But they say, you know, you spoiled, because we are looking for that boy and he's not there. My answer to them would be, you know, every Raj and Simran are different from the Raj and Simran now film. So you just got to find the boy that fits you, and you got to find the girl who fits you, and that's Raj and Simran. And that's, I think that's the universal appeal of that film, that everybody's Raj and Simran and nobody's Raj and Simran. So you just got to find your own Rajness and Simranness.
When you see today, when you think of love, there is so much cynicism. But if a film like that, which is such a pure love story, can lie in the hearts of every Indian and Asian for over 1,000 weeks, that means that the power exists, and that film resonates that power.
Beech mein uske ladki bhagi ja rahi hai white kapde pehne, kya lagega?
I liked the script when I heard it. I remember telling Adi also, I said, it's a perfect script. And he was like, yeah, we worked very hard on it and all that. And he narrated it to me. We said yes, and we just kind of made the film.
I think Adi had seen a film of Kajal's, and he was so floored by her performance. And he felt, kudos to him, because he felt that she could do any role.
I think that's the reason why he wanted to cast her, because she was, again, so different. She looked like nobody else. Today, you can have people, oh, she looks a bit like Kajal, but Kajal was the original, you know, the way she looks, it was very unique.
I think we were all younger, we were boys and girls, I would like to say, at that point of time, and we're men and women now. We became friends, not became friends, because we were already friends when we did DDLJ. But I think it was a bonding point. There was always this genuine warmth, there was always this ease and this familiarity that probably, you know, we would not have with people that you have worked with, that we have worked with in other films as well?
I don't think either of us has ever told the other how to act. We've just appreciated. I think we have appreciated the fact that we both come very, very easy with it. I know she knows that if she's going wrong, I'll take care of it. I know she knows that if I go wrong, she'll take care of me and, you know, we'll work out something.
The one thing that I was reluctant to do was that towel song. I was like, Adi, what is this shit? Meri khabo me jo aaye, aake mujhe chhed jaaye. You know, I'm going to be in a towel in the whole bloody song. And what is this crap? And I'm not that kind of this thing. She's like, don't worry about it. We'll handle it. We'll manage it and all that. Of course, it was handled very, very nicely and very aesthetically, and there was nothing that, you know, kind of got anybody on the wrong side about it, but yeah.
Mere khabon mein jo aaye, so it was a whole house set in Filmistan studio, and there was this white skirt that we tried. So Adi said, it's a bit long. So I said, okay, let's cut it now only. So I got my tailor to cut it, and just dekhte, it became even shorter. And it became so short that she was like, but it's so short. And we were like, so Adi was like, no, I think it's really cool. So actually that skirt was actually cut on set, and also the way Adi shot it in rain, she's with her mother, and it became quite iconic in the sense of that white shirt, white skirt, and it's yet remembered as a vision. She danced really cool. Good looking films is what came back with Dilwale. I think we lost that somewhere in the late 80s and early 90s. Everything had gone very garish. Very young, very spirited, very doing what you want to do, kind of space for your youngsters.
And of course, the scene where Shah Rukh and we wake up in bed together, which was another one of those scenes where it sounded very great when we were writing it, but when we eventually shot it, it was hysterically funny.
Clap 53. Action. What are you talking about? Shah Rukh, look.
It was supposed to be this intimate scene, and Adi had probably imagined it as one of those, you know, steamy scenes where the chemistry gets hot, and we both of us were just sitting and looking at each other and hysterically laughing.
Okay, now let's do it. Let's do proper take. Now I'm not going to laugh this time, so you better not laugh this time. Okay.
The anticipation of this happening makes us laugh, especially the sound of the zip.
Please, bolo ki tum jhoot bol rahe ho.
ठीक है, ठीक है, मैं झूठ बोल रहा हूँ. मेरी आँखें झूठ बोल रही हैं.
किशन भी झूठ बोल रहा है.
I think we did 50 retakes of that. He was puckered with us. He wanted to shoot us in the head at that point of time. He just wanted to take out a gun if he had one at that point of time and kill us.
Kajal is a brat. She's loud, she's noisy, she's just difficult to control. Adi used to get fed up, Farida Jalal used to want to kill her. I had to control her because I was her best friend, so I would like, you know, Kajal, behave yourself.
And Karan, you turn around this side.
Actors prepare by reading dialogues. Some actors prepare by kind of, you know, getting into a quiet zone, thinking about the moment. Kajal's preparation is this nervous energy.
I remember on set, when she would be shooting the most dramatic moments or the most, you know, moments which required a lot more histrionics from her, she would be at her craziest best. You know, she'd be jumping around the set, she'd be chasing people, she'd be throwing things at them, she'd be eating my props.
She needs to come and hug you tight, needs to push you, pull you, slap you, scream at you, screech on set. Like Yash Uncle used to call her Pagli. That was his pet name for her, Pagli, because she was all over the place. But jab wo shot shuru ho jata tha, the camera rolled and you said action, bang, boom, she was on.
Mm-hmm.
तुम ठीक कहती हो माँ, मैं भी कितनी नादान हूँ ना, मुझे तो ये भी नहीं पता कि वो मुझसे प्यार करता भी है कि नहीं।
What I liked about DDLJ are the female characters. They have these really cute rebellions, you know, throughout the film. You have the film opening with the whole family jiving to this really like western number, and then as soon as Amrish Puri's character enters, they just stop dancing and switch the music to like some really boring Hindi track. Kajol, she seems really obedient, but she's perpetually trying to grasp whatever she wants. Like, she wants to go to Europe, she manages to do that. And she's the one who leaves the cowbell outside the door, you know, for Shah Rukh to find. So, in a way, she is the one who kind of proposes to Shah Rukh. So, the, you know, the characters are kind of cute and rebellious in that way.
If you analyze it very deeply, actually, as I told you, it alters the course of the way... Like, you know, rebellion is wrong. Like, you know, conversations, communication is of essence. So the first thing, it broke that stereotype. It made her mother very strong, because though she acknowledged what was her mistake, she had a discussion with her daughter and said, I don't want to be that. I want you to be your own woman. I don't want you to be who I was. That was a progressive conversation.
So what happened if that girl is? She will live her own life.
We were taking a close-up. I said, this is the reaction. आप शर्मा जाती हैं, तो शी टेल्स मी व्हाट इज शर्मा, ऐसे तेरा कसूर नहीं।
इधर सहरा सजा के रखना, चेहरा छुपा के रखना,
अरे बाप रे,
इधर से ही हाथ ऐसे यूं आ जाए कि मैंने क्या कर दिया, मैंने ये एक्शन क्यों किया।
शर्माना क्या होता है, किसी ने कभी सिखाया है शर्माना? शर्माना उसको उसका मतलब क्या होता है? So I remember Adi actually doing the shot for me, that you know you have to feel shy and look down or whatever. I said, Adi, you have to do this for me. I don't know how to feel shy. He said, feel it from inside, feel it from inside. It was just not happening. And that shot was hysterical. Then finally he was just like, just put your eyes down, just forget it. I don't want a real shot. I don't want you to act. Just put your eyes down and do what I tell you to do.
There's a lot of respect, there's a lot of love, there's a lot of kindness, and there's a lot of acceptance of the fact that we are not special. I think that's what bonds us together. If I may say something personal, we have the best four eyes in the business. Nobody has better four eyes. If you looked all over the country, you'll not find better four eyes or better two pair of eyes than Kajol and me.
I couldn't imagine that he could write a script like that, which was young, it was emotional, and it was traditional, which for a 22-year-old young man to do at that time, who's had a very modern education, was amazing.
He used to come every day for 3 weeks and talk about the film, the core idea, and we used to just talk about it. He used to ask me questions, ask me for some inputs. But he had the film very clearly sorted in his head. And he literally wrote that film, I think, in the span of 3 to 4 weeks.
Adi, Aditya Chopra, great director. He is also known as Bruder, therefore his expression, you know, when he's scratching his upper lip is very, very famous to him.
He was very different on the sets. We call him Kadus. You know, he gets very, like, he's quite okay when we are playing games. And I mean, he fights and everything, but on the sets, he was like really strict. His brows are closely knit, and he's got a scowl on his face. He doesn't smile.
He's trying to behave like totally casually, like as though he does not notice the camera, but actually he's very camera conscious. You can make that out in the nervous movements of his fingers on his eyes. Yes, and now he's taking, trying to behave like as though there's nothing absolutely wrong with this whole point. And he's going to beat me up any moment now. But I think I should wait. There is still time. Yes, he has smiled. He has smiled.
At the script level, I think he thought he was making something phenomenally trend-setting at that point of time. But when we saw the film, we were like, this is not trend-setting. This is like the same, you know, the same old, basically. And so at that point, we were like, ah, achhe lag rahe hain, achhi picture hai. But I mean, there's nothing new and different about it. Obviously, the audiences disagreed with us at that point of time and today.
Adi, just come here, sit down, huh? And explain it to me. I don't understand. I thought your film was different.
My film is not different. I'm making the most commercial, cliche, Kapoori movie ever made. I'm making the origin story in the book. You all thought it's a different film?
I thought maybe he was aiming for the Oscars.
You mean trade guide will say story is routine?
But has
and
chances at
box and direction by Aditya Chopra passes muster.
Oh no!
That's the lingo.
As long as the Kapoori's clap and the song comes, I'm happy.
What song?
Hopefully this one.
They won't clap on this, they should cry.
Adi wanted to break the whole chiffon sari myth. So he was like, I don't want to give Kajal a chiffon sari. I want to give Kajal a satin sari. So satin sari urti nahi hawa mein. So Yash Uncle would come and tell me, satin sari kyun de diya abhi? Hawa mein nahi ud raha. And if a chiffon sari doesn't fly, then it won't look beautiful. So there were little things that Adi in his own way was trying to kind of change, to change the Yash Raj formatting. But eventually, it's a quintessential Yash Raj film because Adi's soul is from his father. Like, nobody knows much about Aditya Chopra. He's such a kind of a Loch Ness monster, you know, hiding somewhere. You feel he's a myth, he doesn't even exist. But actually, Aditya Chopra is the most romantic man I know. He's full of romance. But he is a romantic in denial. And I think that's what happens. When you're in denial about something, cinema becomes a vicarious platform for you to express all your inert energies. So all Adi's romance, his sense of love, his sense of passion, all that explodes on cinema because otherwise he's not a very emotionally expressive man.
I by nature call everyone when I get on set, sir. So Adi, sir, to me on sets. It'll never be any other way. I may disagree with Adi, I'll fight with him and we can have huge discussions personally and abuse each other in private. But on the sets, he's sir. And I think so is he like that, you know. He's very clear that actors are to be loved and respected and cajoled. So if there's something to be told, it's done at a very personal, sweet level.
I don't know whether anybody knows that about him, but he used to go watch First Day First Show and give his own review of every movie that he watched and how much the money the film would make. So when you know a person like that, you know that he's really, really focused and really, really filmy.
It's a top shot that we can
do. Your chin up, you can just open your eyes, you'll get the reaction. Okay? Aankh khuli, phir se, aap chale.
Like I remember when he was doing Ajane, Mere Dil Ka Kya Ho Gaya. None of us knew really what was in his mind.
Mujhe kiss karne ki himmat kaise ki? Apne aapko samajhta kya? Piche pad gaya.
People like Sarojji was telling him like, Adi, what are you doing? You're messing this song up. And even like parts of the climax, people like Manji and Dad were not very excited about the way he wanted to treat that climax. Sarojji, Manji, Dad, they were all the best of their field and they are telling Adi that you're doing something wrong and he still didn't listen to them. He just listened to his gut and then finally, I remember it is, you know, Sarojji's greatness that she actually came one day to the house and told Adi that, you know, I was wrong, you were right.
Adi was about to throw me out of the picture. I landed one day late and they were about to take the first shot of that song where she's wearing a black gown and he's in a black suit. He was that time shouting and screaming and telling his father, I'm going to throw out Sarojji. Anyhow, I landed on time before he threw me out.
We had some senior members on the technical staff and they're all good thinking, lovely people, you know, meaning well for somebody's first film. He said, no, I don't want to do it because I don't believe it should be done like that. So I said, but why take a chance? Yeah, first film, maybe, you know, these people know better than you and I. He said, no, then I would never know what mistakes I made. So if I go wrong, it should be my wrong. And he was very clear that he would not do something which he didn't believe in. Because if it went wrong, he would not know how to rectify it because it wasn't something he wanted to do in the first place.
Adi is a dictator. He's not a director. It's his way or it's definitely the highway. His clarity is something that I will always, I would say, want to emulate and have been inspired by. Because I knew one thing. He always told me, if anyone has a question on set, you must have the answer.
When the narration happened, Anil Bakshi said, if this guy is listening to this picture, ये इसकी आधी भी बना जाएगा तो ये पिक्चर कभी उतरेगी
उतरेगी
ये तेरे परदादा दीवान ब्रिजनाथ कभी स्कूल ही नहीं गए और ये इनके बेटे
देयर इज अ सीन वेयर आई इंट्रोड्यूस शाहरुख टू ऑल द फैमिली मेंबर्स आई टोल्ड आदि कैन आई टेक द नेम्स ऑफ माय ओन अंकल्स एंड ही सेड इट्स ओके
दीवान पुष्करनाथ आठवीं फेल और मैं तेरा बाप मैट्रिक फेल
सो आई रोट टू ऑल ऑफ देम दैट देयर इज अ फिल्म कमिंग दिलवाले दुल्हनिया ले जाएंगे एंड प्लीज आई थिंक यू विल हैव टू एक्सक्यूज मी But all of them called me up and wrote to me. They said, thank you, you made us world famous. In fact, I told him that I want to do, why have you given the bigger role to Amrish ji? I want to do Amrish ji's role. And he said, no, no, let Amrish ji, your role will also have great impact.
Actually, Anupam Kher's character was based on Yash. Yash was a father like that only. He was more a friend to his boys. And I used to keep telling him, nagging him that don't spoil the boys, don't spoil them. He would say कि क्या spoiling? मेरे दोस्त हैं this way I feel happy. Why should you object to it?
जो wild piano जो बजा है वो पहले मैंने try किया आदि ने बोला बहुत bundle बजा रहा है तो बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है play something wild तो फिर और wild बजा तो नहीं बजा बोला तू हट तेरे से नहीं होगा and that wild piano has been played by Aditya Chopra.
So often he would sit at the table and, you know, play an sort of an extempo kind of a dholak on the table and sing it. And you know that Adi sings pretty well. Nobody would know about that, but he does.
Action mein hum log ne bada acha piece banaya usme ki pehli baar Dilwale Dulhaniya mein action ho raha hai, maza lenge us cheez ka. To bada acha music bana to Adi ne bola nahi nahi ye to ja hi nahi raha hai meri picture. तो हमने बोला रिएक्शन हो रहा है इसमें तो ड्रामेटिक म्यूजिक होना चाहिए बोला नहीं नहीं इसमें हम लोग ऐसा करते हैं इसमें हम लोग मेहंदी लगा के बजाते हैं तो मुझे हंसी आ गई मैं बोला क्या बोल रहे हो यार मेहंदी लगा के तो पूरा सीन ही गिर जाएगा इसमें बोला नहीं नहीं बहुत अच्छा लगेगा इसको एग्रेसिव ढोल में बजाओ आप लोग और इसमें कुछ करो इसमें कुछ में पीस को जमाते हैं इसको तुम लोग पिक्चर में देखना लोग ताली मारेंगे इस पर आई मीन लिटरली व्हेन वी वेंट टू सी द फिल्म वो जो बैकग्राउंड आदि ने करवाया वहाँ पे ढोल बजवाया और हमने फिर कोरस उसको एग्रेसिवली किया वहाँ ताली मार
ताली बजती
Adi went to see the first show at Gaiety, I think it was. And he went there only after the interval. He was sitting there. And the moment that scene finished, you know, where Shah Rukh gives a long dialogue and all that, and then he leaves. He left after that.
मैं तुम्हारे काबिल नहीं हूँ। तो क्या हुआ अगर तुम्हारे चेहरे के सिवाय मुझे कोई और चेहरा दिखाई नहीं देता? तो क्या हुआ अगर तुम्हारे नाम के सिवाय मुझे कोई और नाम याद नहीं रहता?
So he came back and he said, माँ पिक्चर बहुत बड़ी हिट है। So I said, बेटा वो तुझे कैसे पता चला? तुमने तो पहला शो देखा और तू पूरा देखा भी नहीं। This is not one person moved during that long dialogue.
I went to a hall where people were talking when the scene was on, and as an actor, that's a very insecure thing. And I'm like, oh God, shit, Adi's right. People have lost the thread of the film. And then I heard them closely, and they were repeating the dialogues. So it was the second time audience, Bauji, theek kehte hain.
They were so with the film, he said, Ma, the picture is a very big hit. He came and told me.
And I called him up, I was in Jaipur, I remember. And I said, yaar, log to dialogue wala bol rahe hain. He said, yaar, mujhe bhi lag raha hai, yaar, wo theek ho gaya, yaar. Log bore nahi hue, baj gaye hum log.